Hello and welcome to June 2016 question 2. Given the matrices M equals that and N equals that, find the matrix product MN and NM. So the matrix product MN is given by matrix M times matrix N. And when we do this operation, we will obtain a matrix of order 3 by 3, which is given by 3 0 0 0 3 0 0 0 3, and this matrix is equal to 3 times the identity matrix. Similarly, NM will be equal to matrix N times matrix M, and this product will equally give us a 3 by 3 matrix, which is given by 3 0 0 0 3 0 0 0 3, and this is called 3 times the identity matrix. From here we can conclude that MN is equal to NM. Do not make the mistake to say that matrix M and N are inverses. That is not correct, because MN is equal to 3 times I, similarly NM is 3 I's. The question continues as follows. Hence, find M inverse. The word hence here has been used, which means we must continue with the previous solution that we have to work in this particular part. So, we have been asked to look for M inverse. So, I'm going to use the identity MN equals 3i's. And M times 1 over 3n should be equal to I. From here, the product of two matrices giving us the identity in matrix implies one of them is the inverse of the other. So M times 1 over 3n giving me the identity matrix means the inverse of matrix M is 1/3 of matrix N, and we can simplify to have 1 over 3 times all the entries in matrix N, and this is what it results in. We have minus 1/3, 0, 1/3, 5 on 3, 0, minus 2 on 3, 2, 1, minus 1. Don't forget, guys, to click on the subscribe button so that in case we upload any video, you'll not be left out. And equally, click on the notifications button so that whenever any video is uploaded, you'll be one of the first to be notified. You will not be left out in anything. And if you find out that anyone is using our content, don't forget to get to us on gcematpanel@gmail.com. In need of past questions for any subject, you can visit our site gcematpanel.blogspot.com. www.gcematpanel.blogspot.com. The B part of the question reads, the transformation represented by the matrix M maps the points A, B, and C to the points 306, 053, 101 respectively. Find the coordinates of A, B, and C. According to this transformation, the points 306, 053, and 101 are respectively the images of the points A, B, and C. So what we have been given here are the images, and the transformation MP maps the points P to P prime. This implies solving for P will give us M inverse times P prime. That is, we multiply both sides, that is pre-multiplication of both sides by the inverse of matrix M, and that will give us P, which we are looking for, to be equal to M inverse times P prime. Note that the point P, or the matrix P, consists of the points A, B, and C. So putting this or simplifying will give us 1/3, that is M inverse times N, which we had before. Now times the matrix P prime, that is the matrix of all the images of A, B, and C. And that gives us 3, 0, 1, 0, 5, 3, 6, 3, 1. Where 3, 0, 6 is A prime, 053 is B prime, and 101 is C prime. When we do this multiplication, simplify, we obtain 110, 1 minus 2, 2, 0, 1, 1, which are the points A, B, and C respectively. Therefore, our A is 110, B is 1 minus 2, 1, and C is 0, 2, 1. The next question will be question 3. And please don't forget to subscribe and click on the notifications button so that for any new video that comes in, you will have a copy. Thank you so much and stay tuned.